हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वंस अगेन आई एम बैक विद द पार्ट 3 ऑफ योर चैप्टर फ्रॉम द बायोलॉजी सेक्शन, दैट इज टिश्यू. इन द प्रीवियस सेक्शन वी हैड डिस्कस्ड अबाउट द एपिथेलियल टिश्यूज एंड द वेरियस काइंड्स ऑफ एपिथेलियल टिश्यूज अलॉन्ग विद देयर लोकेशंस एंड द फंक्शंस दे परफॉर्म इन द ह्यूमन बॉडी. नाउ इन द प्रेजेंट वीडियो वी विल बी डिस्कसिंग अबाउट द कनेक्टिव टिश्यूज which is a yet another kind of tissue that are very important in our body. As the name suggests, connective tissue, they play a very important role of connecting different parts of our body with one another so that all the body parts can work in a coordinated way and can satisfy each other's requirement. Okay, so let us get started with the connective tissue. As you can see over the screens, the connective tissue is well clear over here. Article 6.3.2, this is. The very first connective tissue that we are going to discuss is blood. Blood, which is a connective tissue and has a matrix which is fluid in nature. That means blood has a fluid matrix. Therefore, the blood is also referred to as a fluid connective tissue. Why fluid? Because it has a fluid matrix. Connective, because it connects different parts of the body. And tissue, because it is a cluster of various cells. The various cells that constitute blood are red blood corpuscles, white blood corpuscles, and the platelets. Red blood corpuscles that are also known as erythrocytes, white blood corpuscles that are also known as leukocytes, and the platelets that are also known as thrombocytes. All the kind of blood cells perform specific functions in the body. For example, if we talk about RBCs, they are concerned with the transport of oxygen and the carbon dioxide from one part to the another. When we talk about WBCs, they are an immunity providing system to our body. That means they protect us against various infections and diseases. Platelets, on the other side, are meant for coagulation or clotting of blood. Right? Over here, there is a figure that clearly explains the structure of all kind of tissues. For example, in figure 6.10, A is the type of blood cells represented over here. You can see the different kinds of white blood corpuscles are represented: the neutrophils, eosinophils, basophils, lymphocytes, and the monocytes. Actually, these are the two. There are two kinds of WBCs: the granulocytes and the agranulocytes that are being discussed over here. If we talk about a RBC, you can see over here a red blood corpuscle is indicated. Our RBC is biconcave in shape and is red in color. The red color of RBC is due to the presence of a red color pigment in it, that is hemoglobin. Hemoglobin is the only pigment that is responsible for the conduction of oxygen through to the different parts of body. So as you can read out the very first para, blood has a fluid matrix called plasma. Plasma is the fluid part of blood in which red blood corpuscles, WBCs, and the platelets remains embedded. The plasma contains proteins, salts, and hormones. Blood flows and transports gases, digested food, hormones, and the waste materials to different parts of the body. Right? So I guess the blood is very clear to you. As I explained to you, that is all given in the paragraph. Now let us move to the yet another kind of tissue, that is a hard kind of tissue, a hard connective tissue, because it has a hard matrix made up of calcium and phosphorus. And the tissue is bone. Right? A bony structure, or the bones are the particular kind of connective tissue that gives an organism a particular framework of body. It also supports the structure of organisms. It anchors the muscles and supports the main organs of the body. It is a strong and non-flexible tissue. Bone cells are embedded in a hard matrix that is composed of calcium and phosphorus compounds. Right? The bone cells are also referred to as osteocytes, because the term osteo is used for bone. Osteocyte means bone cells. A yet another kind of connective tissue that is used in connecting two different bones is referred to as the ligament. As you can see over here in the third para, Ligament, the tissue is very elastic and has considerable strength. Ligaments contain very little matrix and connect bones with the bones. Yet another kind of tissue that connects bones with the muscles are known as tendons. Tendons are fibrous tissue with great strength but limited flexibility. On one side, where ligaments have extensive strength or extensive flexibility, tendons have got a limited flexibility but a considerable strength. Right? The ligament connects two bones with each other, whereas tendon connects muscles to the bones. Another kind of connective tissue is a cartilage that has a widely spaced cells within it. The solid matrix is composed of proteins and sugars within the cartilage. The cartilage is smoothened the bone surfaces and at the joints and is also present in the nose, ear, trachea and larynx. Right? We can form the cartilage of ears. Why? Because cartilage is a kind of connective tissue that is very soft. Right? The major locations in our body, if we talk about the human body, then the major locations wherever you can find out cartilage is your ear. Your ear is completely made up of the cartilaginous, the ear pinna. The structure of ear that you can see outside that is visible to you is the pin, is made up of cartilage. Other than this, the septum that divides the nostrils of your nose, the two parts, the two entry points of your nose is separated by a septum that is also cartilaginous, right? The cartilage consists of a matrix made up of proteins and sugars that is called a hyaline matrix, and therefore the cartilages are also referred to as hyaline cartilage. Other than this, yet another kind of tissue is a areolar connective tissue that is found beneath the skin and the muscles. It supports various organs and is also present in the bone marrow. It fills the space inside the organs and supports them internally. It gives them strength against the mechanical shocks and jerks, so that no kind of mechanical shock or jerk should damage them, right? And adipose tissue are the tissues that are usually a stored form of fat in the body. Whenever a person consumes a fatty diet up more than a limit that is not being consumed by the body for getting energy, that gets transformed into adipose tissue, right? This adipose tissue acts as an insulator for body, and it also provides chubbiness to the body of organism, right? Within the figure, you can see over here different kinds of tissues have been described. Like in the B, you can see bone tissue. Haversian canal, as I told you, Haversian canal is containing blood vessels and the nerve fibers. Canaliculus contains slender process of bone cells or the osteocyte. This is the structure of bone cells or osteocytes, right? And these star-shaped black-colored structures on the border of blue center is the Haversian canal. Over here, there is a structure of cartilage. The cartilaginous cells are known as chondrocyte, just like the bone cells are called osteocyte. And because the cartilage consists of a hyaline matrix, therefore the cartilage in our body are usually referred to as hyaline cartilage. When we talk about our areolar tissue, as it is described in the figure D, the areolar tissue contains fibrous tissues, and therefore the fibers are meant for strength in the body. So the areolar tissue fills the space beneath the muscles, between the muscles and the internal organs, and it supports the internal organs against any kind of mechanical shock and injury. The D is adipocyte, that is an adipose tissue, adipose cell containing fatty droplets, which provides insulation to the body and gives chubbiness to the body, right? Let us move to the yet another kind of tissues, that are the muscular tissues. When we talk about the muscular tissue, our body contains different kinds of muscles depending on their location and the function with which they are concerned. Muscular tissue consists of elongated cells, also called muscle fibers. This tissue is responsible for movement in our body, and the muscle tissues are provided with special proteins that help them in contraction and relaxation. If I tell you the name of a special protein, then actin and myosin are the proteins that are meant for contraction and relaxation of muscles within the body, right? The very first kind of muscles are skeletal muscles. Let us discuss from here. As we see, when we talk about some of the muscles that help us moving our body parts, like we can move our hand, we can bend our hand by the elbow, we can bend our leg by the knee. So, right? So this kind of movement, with what we do like in walking, in grabbing something or while running, this kind of movement is becomes possible by the voluntary muscles. Voluntary means something that is under the control of our will. We can control the movement of those muscles, right? So the muscles that are voluntary, that means they are under the control of our will, are referred to as skeletal muscles, as they are mostly attached to the bones and help in body movements. Under the microscope, these muscles show alternate dark and light striations or bands. That is why the muscles are also known as striated muscles. The cells of this tissue are long, cylindrical, unbranched and multinucleated. You can see a structure over here. Long या elongated structure आपको ये part में दिख रहा है, multinucleated है because you can see more than one nuclei. Alternate dark or light bands आपको दिख रहे हैं and unbranched structure है. There is no branching you can find out. Right? So this is the very kind of muscle that is the skeletal muscle that is connected with the bones of our body and provides smooth movements by their contraction and relaxation. Because the muscles are under the control of ourselves, that is why the muscles are also known as voluntary muscles. Because the muscles contain alternate dark and light striations on them, that is why the muscles are also known as striated muscles. The movement of food in the alimentary canal, let us move to the second para now. The movement of food in the alimentary canal or the contraction and relaxation of blood vessels are involuntary movements. हमारे alimentary canal में once the food is swallowed through the gullet, एक बार जब आप food को निगल लेते हैं, then the movement of food is not under your control. Now it gets out of our control, right? So the alimentary canal that has involuntary muscles within it that leads the movement of food into the different parts of alimentary canal, like from esophagus to the stomach and then into small intestine. This kind of movement is controlled by yet another kind of muscles that are the involuntary muscles. Involuntary means they are not under the control of ourselves. Same is the case with blood vessels. You cannot regulate your blood pressure by your will, right? They are also found in the iris of eye, in the ureters and in the bronchi of lungs. The cells are long with pointed ends. The involuntary muscles are spindle-shaped muscles with uninucleate condition, that is, they have a single nucleus. They are also called unstriated muscles because there are no alternate light and dark bands over them. The B figure represents the involuntary muscles. You can see the spindle-shaped structure. Spindle-shaped ka matlab hota hai, a structure that is pointed or tapering from both the ends and is thickened at the middle. Each of the muscle cell is containing a single nucleus and there is no striations, so the muscles will be known as striated, unstriated muscles or the involuntary muscles. The last kind of muscles that we have to study is the muscles of heart, that are also known as the cardiac muscles. They show rhythmic contraction and relaxation throughout the life, that is from the, that is before the birth. Let me tell you, the heart develops within an organism at about 1 to 1.5 month of fetus, and from that time till the death of a person, the heart beat continuously without getting any kind of fatigue. This is only possible because of these special kind of muscles that do not get fatigue throughout the life. These are the involuntary muscles and also known as cardiac muscles, but these involuntary muscles are a special kind of muscles which are cylindrical, branched and uninucleate. These muscles are cylindrical, branched and uninucleate kind of muscles. So now let us talk about the yet another kind of tissue, that is the last tissue we have to deal with in this chapter, and this is nervous tissue. The tissue that is responsible for carrying over signals from one part of the body to the other part, usually brain, is called the nervous tissue. The nervous tissue is responsible for transmitting the stimulus very rapidly from the place of reception to the place of coordination or control. The highest coordinating center within the body of organisms is the brain. Wherever the sensory signals are interpreted and then a particular response is created, this particular response is transmitted to the body or to the organ of action or the muscle of action by the motor neurons. So the sensory neurons and the motor neurons completes the pathway, and these neurons consist of nervous tissues. Now the structure of a nervous tissue or a neuron unit is given over here. You can see from the starting, first of all, a cell body containing a nucleus in the center. The cell body has on its tips dendrite-like structures. From this cell body, a long elongated projection is going on, that is axon, and the axon is covered at regular intervals by a blue colored sheet. That blue colored sheet is known as the myelin sheet, right? At the end of axon, you can see there are four endings that are the nerve endings. These are also known as synaptic knobs. So this is a complete neuron unit. गाइज ऐसे कई सारे न्यूरॉन्स मिलकर एक नर्वस टिश्यू क्रिएट करते हैं, मतलब एक कंप्लीट पाथवे, एक चेन बनती है. वन ऑफ द न्यूरॉन देन द अदर एंड मिलियंस ऑफ न्यूरॉन्स आर कनेक्टिंग विद ईच अदर टू फॉर्म अ चेन विद इन द बॉडी सो दैट फ्रॉम ईच एंड एवरी पार्ट ऑफ द बॉडी द सिग्नल्स कुड बी रिसीव्ड एंड देन सेंड टू द ब्रेन फॉर इंटरप्रिटेशन. द ब्रेन इंटरप्रीट्स द रिसेप्टर रिसेप्शन और द ब्रेन इंटरप्रीट्स द सेंसरी सिग्नल्स एंड देन अ मोटर रिस्पॉन्स इज क्रिएटेड दैट इज सेंट बैक टू द मसल और द ऑर्गन ऑफ एक्शन. राइट, दीज सिग्नल्स आर ट्रांसमिटेड बाय द नर्वस टिश्यूज विद इन द बॉडी सो फास्ट, द स्पीड ऑफ ट्रांसमिशन इज सो फास्ट दैट विद इन अ पार्ट ऑफ सेकेंड द ऑर्गेनिज्म और द एनिमल्स आर रेडी टू मेक द रिस्पॉन्स. जस्ट टेक एन एग्जाम्पल गाइज, यू आर जस्ट टचिंग अ हॉट प्लेट और अ हॉट टब that is very hot and can damage your skin, right? So as and when you touch it, within a second you will remove your hand back. Why? Because it is harmful. But who told you that it is harmful for your hand or it may cause burns on your skin? Your brain. So this process of touching a hot plate and removing the hand back is a very fast process, but within this process there is a very very important pathway involved. First of all, when you touch the hot plate, the nervous tissues take the signal to the brain that we are touching something hot. And then brain told us that on touching a hot thing, the skin gets burns and therefore you need to remove your hand. तो बेटा पहले सेंसरी सिग्नल्स हमारे हैंड से या स्किन से ब्रेन तक गए और ब्रेन से एक मोटर रिस्पॉन्स क्रिएट हुआ कि हाथ को वहां से हटाना है और तब आपने वहां से अपने हाथ को हटा लिया. ये पूरा प्रोसेस इतना फास्ट था दैट यू कैन नॉट इवन इमेजिन द स्पीड ऑफ कंडक्शन ऑफ इम्पल्सिस. ऑलराइट, सो इन दिस वे द कंप्लीट चैप्टर ऑफ योर्स इज कंप्लीटेड नाउ. आई होप यू लुक यू लाइक द कंटेंट. द कंटेंट वॉज प्रीटी क्लियर टू यू. रिवाइज इट. Be ready for your exams. Stay safe. Stay healthy. All right. Bye-bye.